Okay, let's go over here to Galatians. You can't ever get enough, too much of Galatians. Galatians 3:16. Now to Abraham and his seed were the promises made. He saith not unto seeds as of many, but as of one, and to thy seed, which is Christ. And this I say, that the covenant that was confirmed before God in Christ, the law, which was 430 years after, cannot disannul, that it should make the promise of none effect. For if the inheritance be of the law, it is no more of promise, but God gave it to Abraham by promise. Therefore, for if the inheritance be of the law, it is no more of promise, but God gave it to Abraham by promise. Wherefore then serveth the law? It was added because of transgressions, till the seed should come to whom the promise was made, and it was ordained by angels in the hand of a mediator. This is why, when the pastor was talking about Leviticus, and wherefore then serveth the law? It was added because of transgressions, till the seed, which is Jesus Christ, came, should come to whom the promise was made, and it was ordained by angels in the hand of a mediator. So we're not living under the law of the Old Testament, Leviticus. So the pastor that was saying the government should kill gays, excuse me, but there's not a law in the United States of America that we're supposed to call kill gays. I don't care what planet you're from, mister. I wish we could hear from you to see how far you've advanced since a week or two ago. You just, just smashed your hand down on your pulpit, and just, you look at that video, there's so much anger coming out of you. I pray God convict you and hold you accountable for your hatred and your evil. I'm not cursing you, sir. I'm asking God to convict you just like He convicts all of us of sin. Wherefore then serveth the law, Leviticus, that you're talking about? It was added because of transgressions for all of us. Okay, all of us. We were all born into sin, okay? I mean, every single day we can get an evil thought of unbelief, even fear, anger, any kind of thing that does not line up with the perfection of God, which we can never really attain to. We work at it. Wherefore then serveth the law? It was added because of transgressions, till the seed should come to whom the promise was made, and it was ordained by angels in the hand of a mediator. Now, a mediator is not a mediator of one, but God is one. Is the law then against the promises of God? God forbid, no. For if there had been a law given which could have given life, verily righteousness should have been by the law. But the Scripture hath concluded all under sin, that the promise by faith of Jesus Christ might be given to them that believe. But before faith came, we were kept under the law, shut up unto the faith which should afterward be revealed. Wherefore the law was our schoolmaster to bring us unto Christ. So if you're living under that law, pastor, you haven't even come to Christ. It's like I tweeted, you need Jesus Christ, that we might be justified by faith. This is for individuals, okay? This Bible is for the individual, okay? I can't save you. I can't save a gay person. I can't save you. I can't save the person that's not gay that's a sinner. We were all born into sin, okay? If we're going to do this and we're going to hate people because they're sinners, then what's the use of Jesus Christ come? Let's go all the way back to Adam and Eve and say, you know, the government should kill them because they're the ones that sinned, and we were born into sin because of them, so let's kill them. But after that faith has come, we are no longer under a schoolmaster. For ye are all the children of God by faith. Everybody's sins in the whole world by faith have been forgiven. He's already died once for all. Okay, it's just a matter of people coming to Jesus, repenting, yes, of all of our sins, our high-mindedness, our better-than-thouest attitudes, because we think we have arrived. Oh, holier-than-thouest, whitewashed. For ye are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. For as many of you as have been baptized into Christ have put on Christ. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither bond nor free. There is neither male nor female. For ye are all one in Christ Jesus. And if ye be Christ, then are ye Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. I'm going to stop right there. You know, and this is for us who have arrived to Christ, have actually given our lives to Christ and ask him to come in. But, you know, and then there's another pastor over there that saying God's going to cut down Taylor Swift for, you know, aligning herself with the gays or whatever. You know, you can look it up. Pastor, comma, Taylor Swift, cut down. God's going to cut down. Be careful, Pastor. Be careful. That doesn't fly back on you, sir. Okay, so Father, I lift it all up to you, Lord. Have mercy on all of us. We have all sinned, Lord. Even those that of us that have been saved 40 years and more, or whatever. We haven't arrived. We have only arrived to you. We've only acknowledged that the kingdom of heaven is at hand, and we repent of our unbelief. Forgive us, Lord. We confess we have sinned with our unbelief and our better than thouest attitudes, which brings nobody to Christ. They just look at us like we're nutcases, religious nutcases with hatred in our hearts. And yeah, I like fire and brimstone preaching, don't get me wrong. But that needs to be applied to us holier-than-thouest ones that sit in the pews. I don't sit in the pews. But you go ahead. So, I lift up everybody out there that loves God, that loves Jesus, that hasn't arrived like the rest of everybody else. And there is only one church, and I love the Catholics and I love the Protestants, so I'll just leave it to all you people, the experts out there, to figure that one out. I know what happened. I'm gonna keep studying, but there is only one church, and I'm gonna respect the Catholics, and God bless them. When they see Jesus in that little Eucharist, I'm not going to bash them for it, because I see a lot more love of God. I mean, they talk about, you know, at least the Catholics, you know, they talk about, you know, let's pray for the unborn. You know, do I ever see, I mean, there are Protestants that are pro-life, of course, but from the leadership of the church, of the Protestants. Okay, so, you know, there's all kinds of things we can talk about. I'm not against you. God's not against you. God bless your day. In Jesus Christ's holy name, amen.